It's been 18 months since I was last in Bangkok, and the bar scene in the city has evolved at an incredible rate. Dozens of amazing new bars have popped up, including some that have already charted on Asia's top 50 bars list. The first video I posted on this channel was a Bangkok video, and we're due for an update. So, let's go to all the best new bars in Bangkok. First stop on this tour is the biggest new opening Bangkok has seen in years, Mahaneum. Already placing in the top 20 of the Global 50 Best list, as well as earning the award for Asia's Best New Opening 2023. Resourcefulness is the name of the game when it comes to the cocktail menu here, with the goal of each drink being to take a single ingredient and use it in as many different ways as possible. A drink simply named Cow uses butter, beef fat, milk, and cheese to create one of the most uniquely delicious cocktails I've tasted in years. Cacao uses cocoa butter, cacao husk, fermented juice, and so on. The resourcefulness is amplified with some seriously innovative cocktail techniques. Hot foam on a cold drink? It takes a lot to blow my mind when it comes to flavor. I've seen almost everything before, but that was a real game-changing moment. Pair that with the fact that the food menu is provided by the Michelin-recommended restaurant on the first floor, and you'll be in for a taste experience that's hard to match. It's super easy to see why Mahaneum has skyrocketed on all the global rankings, because this is a cocktail and hospitality experience that rivals some of the world's best. Keeping on the theme of new, I've been to Bangkok 4 times, and this is my first and last time riding in a tuk-tuk. I nearly fell out of the damn thing more times than I'd like to admit. No, thank you. Our next stop is Gaze, an astrology-themed bar right in the heart of Thong Lo. The room and the menu are themed around different constellations, with the bar backdrop showing different night scenes. Beautiful and mesmerizing to look at, but the backlight makes filming a little bit difficult. That's okay though, because the drinks are delicious, and the stargazing and great bartenders are enough to keep you entertained for hours. .2463 is another new bar in Thong Lo. They call it a speakeasy, but it's basically the exact opposite. Named after the year on the Thai calendar that correlates with the 1920s, 2463 is a loud, opulent, and eccentric bar, perfect for a livelier night out. A great drinks menu paired with staff that know how to have a good time, this is definitely a spot to hit if you want a party. I've been to Bangkok enough times to know that I want to spend most of my time in Chinatown. Amazing food, street life, and of course cocktail bars. The number of new openings in Chinatown alone is enough for an extremely adventurous bar crawl. So, bar crawl we shall. Now, a disclaimer before we begin. Not all of these bars are new, but they're new to me, and that's what matters. First of which is Tep. Definitely not a new bar, but a bar I've never experienced before. They bill themselves as the cultural bar of Thailand, and that is certainly apt. Highlighting Thai ingredients, showcasing Thai musical artists, it's a great bar to experience Thai culture through the medium of alcohol. And it's also the only bar that's open at 4 p.m, so it's where we begin. Right around the corner from Tep is Teens of Thailand and Asia Today, two of the best bars in Bangkok. I won't be visiting those bars today because I've been before, but if you're curious about them, you can watch my first Bangkok video, linked below. The team behind Asia Today and Teens basically rule the Chinatown bar scene because they have two new bars in the area, one of which is Tax. Located above Independence, another bar from the same group that we'll be visiting later, Tax features a cocktail menu that leans heavily towards tea and vinegar, due to certain laws regarding the sale and taxation of alcohol. Vinegar, which is essentially spoiled alcohol, is exempt from these taxes. Drinks feature vinegars made from Riesling, sake, or stout, just to name a few. Spoiled alcohol might sound off-putting, but just know that they've used vinegar superbly, and the drinks are delicious. Just a few steps down the road is Lucky Duck, a Chinatown-themed bar in Chinatown of all places. The decor feels as if you're stepping into a Hollywood rendition of a Shanghai speakeasy, with cocktails evoking legends of Chinese cinema, like Wong Kar-wai and Ang Lee, among others. Drinks contain many Asian market-inspired ingredients, as well as a few ingredients that aren't Asian market-inspired, like cookies and cream Campari, which is one of the coolest ideas I've ever heard and I'm definitely going to attempt to recreate. This is another great Chinatown bar, certainly worth the 3 flights of stairs it took to find it. The fourth stop on this Chinatown tour is another bar by the group behind Asia Today, Teens, and Tax. This one is the Independence Bar. The group dominates Chinatown, and for good reason. They just do not miss with their concepts. Independence evokes the feeling of a dive bar, with its diner-like exterior and interior covered head-to-toe in graffiti. But the cocktail program is a bit more refined, with house-made distillates and cordials and edible garnishes. I love a bar that is extremely casual in every sense and then just blows it out of the water with a great drinks program, which is absolutely what you get at Independence. I can't wait to see what these guys open up next. Thank you. Right in the heart of Chinatown, on the third floor above a dim sum shop, behind a secret bookcase, is Widdershins. A chill, laid-back escape from the street-side chaos down below with a Hollywood-inspired drink menu. This is a great place to take a breather when the crowds on Yawa Rat become a bit too hectic, which is basically all the time. Hex is a great new bar in Chinatown that finds its inspiration from ancient curses and witches' potions. It's Halloween 24/7 at Hex, which is timely considering I visited right around Halloween. Drinks contain ingredients that you'd easily find in a magical potion or poison elixir, like stink bugs, or bat wool, just to name a few. Come to think of it, I did feel an increased amount of confidence and lack of stress after drinking those magical elixirs. That might have been the alcohol, though. The final stop on this Chinatown bar crawl is Glass Half Full. The vibe of this bar feels exactly like an expat bar, and I don't mean that in a bad way. It's a place that feels welcoming, a place that feels like a piece of home away from home. The staff are super friendly, and you can tell they're having just as much fun as their guests, which is always a great thing to see. Glass Half Full is a great place to end a great night. There's a lot of good reasons to stay in Chinatown, but if I'm being honest, I'm staying in this neighborhood for one reason and one reason only. It's not the bars, it's not the street life, it's not the central location. No, it's the Thai curry. You want to know my favorite restaurant in Bangkok? It's Jek Pui, without a doubt. A street-side curry stall hidden down the back alleys of Chinatown, Jek Pui is, in my eyes, the quintessential Thai dining experience. Grab a plate, load it up with one or two of the 12 curry options, post up on a plastic stool, and dig in. Glorious. The best part? It's less than $2 per plate. That is insane. Cocktail bars are expensive, so I need to cut costs somewhere. But truthfully, I would eat here even if it was quadruple the cost. I am not ashamed to admit that I ate here 6 times on this trip. It's that good. Another one of Bangkok's new openings to crack Asia's extended top 50 list, Opium is a New York-inspired cocktail bar hidden on the fourth floor of a former opium den, hence the name. An absolutely massive drinks menu features everything you could possibly want, including riffs on classics, avant-garde techniques and ingredients, sweet drinks, sparkling, boozy, low alcohol, large format, tasting flights, omakase, award winners, and the list goes on and on and on. There is something for everyone, and each drink is a masterclass in flavor and technique. The only thing that could improve this experience? Like, opium. Actual opium. Does anyone have any opium? Ray Cocktail and Bite is a new bar from the team behind Sugar Ray, which is one of my favorite bars in Bangkok. The theme here is Japan, with cocktails and food leaning heavily into Japanese flavors. Yuzu, mango, and green tea combine to form one of the best riffs on a gin and tonic I've tasted in years. Hokkaido melon and shiso make for a perfect twist on what is my all-time favorite cocktail, the daiquiri. And spicy yuzu ceviche might be one of the best dishes I've ever had in a cocktail bar. The food is just as good as the drink. The flavors at Ray will blow your mind, and even the stuff that sounds weird and gross, like a potato and cheese cocktail, is balanced perfectly. In terms of taste, Ray is hard to beat. Pair that with super friendly, talented staff and extremely comfortable atmosphere, and you'll find what I think might be the next bar in Bangkok to crack the top rankings. Man, Bangkok has such a good bar scene. Next stop is a brand new outpost of one of Chiang Mai's best bars, Midlife Crisis. The last thing I need to be reminded about is my unavoidable mortality and the constant perils of daily life. Luckily, Midlife is a place full of friendly people and great drinks that will help you forget about your impending doom. Death isn't something I need to worry about. I'm gonna live forever. Final stop, Inside Bar. I'm kind of at a loss for words as how to explain Inside. Great food? Yes. Great drinks? Absolutely. But there's something extra about Inside that makes it one of the most memorable bar experiences I've had in a long time. From the guests hopping behind the bar making their own drinks, to the head bartender randomly deciding to DJ, his song of choice? Wheels on the Bus Go Round and Round. I am not joking. I would play you the audio if I didn't think I'd get DMCA'd. Everything about this place is chaos, in the best possible way. It evokes a feeling of an after-hours industry party, even for guests who aren't in the industry. Anything goes. If you leave Inside without a smile on your face, there's no hope for you. This is a bar you will not forget. That's it. All the best new bars in Bangkok. Between the time of filming this and editing and publishing, countless new incredible bars have popped up that I couldn't get to. Bar Us, Lost in Thaislation, Fourth Wall, Friends, and Find the Photo Booth, just to name a few. I could go on and on about the new openings that didn't make it into this video. I guess that means one thing. I gotta come back for round 3.